What if I told you that this is text? But it's not one character either, it's actually three. Yes, the emoji that we love and see on a daily basis actually has some pretty interesting implementation details. Welcome to the weird and wacky world of Unicode. Hello and welcome back to another video. To give credit up front, today's video is inspired by a blog post titled Bear plus Snowflake equals Polar Bear. Oh yeah, that will make sense by the end of the video, I promise. Anyway, said article is linked in the video description. To delve deep into emoji, there are a few concepts we first need to understand. Let's start with the fact that emoji is really just text. Yes, that's why you can slip emoji into any part of a message. But then again, to understand that, we have to first define what text even is. For that, we'll have to discuss encoding and Unicode. Very quickly, on the topic of encoding, as you probably know, a computer only stores information as bits, ones and zeros, which we can string together to represent numbers. To get a representation of text, we need to provide a mapping for the numbers. So each number gets mapped to a character on your keyboard. Now, if we have a sequence of numbers, we can go back to our mapping and figure out what text that's supposed to represent. This method of establishing a mapping between numbers and characters is called encoding, and the actual rules saying what number maps to what character is called an encoding scheme. There are many encoding schemes out there, from simple ones like ASCII with a very small set of characters, to huge ones like Unicode, which supports hundreds of thousands of glyphs across hundreds of languages. Unicode is designed to sort of be like the one encoding scheme to rule them all, so it even includes things like mathematical symbols, historical languages, and yes, emoji. Moving forward, whatever quirks we describe about emoji are really quirks of Unicode. And when I talk about code points, we're really referring to the number in which the various characters are mapped to. These code points are expressed in hexadecimal. So for example, the capital letter A is mapped to the code point 41. That's 41 in hexadecimal. Oh, this little program here? Yeah, it's a good tool to explore Unicode and emoji. Let's take a closer look at it. I wrote this program such that if you entered a code point, it would translate that into the relevant character. So to visit the hello example from earlier on, I could write this, or to make things easier, I could pick off the relevant characters from the Unicode palette below. The code points are shown in a box up here, and the characters get decoded into their actual representations down here. You can see that if I were to return to the emoji page and pick one off, its code point is shown. Now, at this juncture, it's important to mention that while yes, Unicode does define what character exists at what code point, it is merely described in words. It's up to the font to define what the characters and emoji actually look like. This issue becomes doubly complicated when you consider the fact that different devices have different fonts installed. Different browsers have different approaches to decoding Unicode. So if you put an emoji on a web page, you can't expect it to look identical across all devices. Some websites and web applications like Twitter or WhatsApp approach this problem by finding emoji code points in text and substituting them with inline graphics. This improves compatibility and ensures that content looks the same no matter what platform you're viewing it on. For us, however, we're not doing that. We're relying on your browser's ability to render the glyphs correctly and for your device to have the right fonts. Therefore, your mileage may vary, but this also makes a good study as to how different devices handle Unicode. In fact, my program takes two approaches here. The output panel on the left uses a generic font in your browser, while the output on the right specifically seeks out an emoji-aware font to render output. Sometimes their outputs differ. Anyway, with all this preamble out of the way, we can start to see exactly what makes emoji exciting. Let's start by immediately issuing a correction. In the name of simplifying things before, I heavily implied that one code point actually corresponds to one character on screen. That's not strictly true. In some contexts, we may be interested in what is known as combining characters. Commonly used for things like diacritics, this is an additional code point coming after a character that modifies it. For example, I could write 61 to get an A, then write 33F after it, which gives that A a double overbar. That's not two characters. That's one character that has been modified by the otherwise invisible character that comes after it. Combining characters may also be used in places like Hangul for the Korean language, which is made up of letters that are combined into a single glyph. Here, you see the word Han, which is made up of three quote points. If I were to insert a space quote point 20 in between the first two glyphs, notice how the word flies apart into its constituent letters. Actually, I lied again. There is a single quote point for the word Han at D55C. So in this particular case, you don't actually have to make up the word using three separate characters. What's extra interesting here is that these two variants look identical side by side, but of course in code, they're not the same. Anyway, I'm digressing. The point is, you can combine multiple quote points together, and this mechanic, when applied to emoji, can do some pretty interesting things. For example, you know how many of the human emojis allow for the setting of different skin tones? Turns out, that's implemented through a set of skin tone modifier quote points. Place down any supported human emoji, then place a skin tone modifier. They'll combine down to one emoji with the selected skin tone. In addition to combinations, certain special symbols act as signals to tell the Unicode renderer to do something it wouldn't normally do. One example of this is variant selectors. Every character is allowed up to 16 variants, though most of them are unused. To specify this, enter a variation selector quote point after a symbol. In my testing, a lot of these variations in text are incredibly subtle. For example, here's a mathematical symbol I've never used before that supposedly stands for less than or equals to. If I enter the quote point for variant selector 1, the stroke at the bottom shifts and becomes diagonal. If I remove the variant selector, it goes back to being horizontal. In a world of emoji, we're probably more interested in variant selectors 15 and 16. You see, many emoji-aware fonts have two variants of emoji characters, an emoji-style color version, which is what we've been seeing, in addition to a more traditional text-style monochrome version. If we plop down an emoji followed by the variant selector 15 with the code point FE0E, we're asking for the emoji to be rendered like text. This allows us to format it to our liking. Conversely, variant selector 16 with the code point FE0F can force certain characters to become rendered as full color emoji, even if they're typically not designed to be seen that way. For example, you may have seen the emoji that looks like a number, but in a box with a blue colored background. Turns out, the underlying code point is just the number itself, but coerced into emoji by using variant selector 16. Again, whether these variants actually exist and work depends on the font and the rendering engine. Notice I have a button here called Emoji Mode. The goal of this toggle is to either force as many or as little full-color emoji rendering as possible. When toggled off, I place the emoji-suppressing variant selector after every character in the palette, in addition to applying a generic font. When toggled on, I use the Force Emoji variant selector with emoji-aware fonts. It's interesting to see how certain characters only have full color representations, while other, obviously graphical glyphs, only have monochrome versions. Alright, here comes the most exciting thing you can do: to explicitly join two emoji that can potentially exist on their own. Let's go back to the example we saw at the beginning of the video, the pirate flag. Place down the black flag, followed by the skull and bones. Of course, these appear as two separate glyphs, which is an entirely reasonable thing to do. However, Unicode supports putting them together. To explicitly say you want to join these two glyphs, use a code point called the zero with joiner at 200D. Notice how that puts the skull and bone symbol onto the flag. This is a single emoji composed of three characters. In some contexts, you may be required to add a variation selector for full color emoji at the end to make this work. Some of these combinations are really quite interesting, like the occupation ones. Take a man, add him to a bit of wheat, and he becomes a farmer. Swap that out for a frying pan, and he becomes a chef instead. Let's try another example to take this to the extreme, and notice just how flexible things can get. While Unicode gives you a family glyph with mom, dad, and a boy, you may want more customizability there, so let's build our own. Man plus woman plus boy. Now we've recreated that emoji. Maybe add some skin tones into the mix, customizing everyone. This emoji is now made up of 8 characters. Don't forget, this is still one emoji. Maybe this family has a daughter too. Let's add her in and customize her skin tone as well. Now, this single emoji is made up of 11 characters. One last example before ending off. Let's add 2 adults, putting a 0 width joiner between them. They now appear in the same emoji. We can also customize their skin tones, and this emoji is now already 5 characters long. Now, let's add a handshake emoji in the middle and join the lot with another 0 width joiner. That is interpreted as holding hands, and we can change the characters around however we like. This emoji is now 7 characters long. Again, this is a single emoji. And there you go. Emoji is interesting thanks to how Unicode is designed. And since it can exploit features like variant selectors and combining creators to create interesting effects. Unfortunately, not every possible combination as defined in the Unicode standard works in my browser. I guess since some combinations are newer, we have to wait till fonts and browsers catch up. For me, this unfortunately also applied to the titular example bear plus snowflake equals the polar bear from that previously mentioned article. I'm only seeing a bear and a snowflake. But I know this works because if I bring this into, say, Telegram, which converts emoji into little pictures inline, I can see that this does indeed get transformed into a polar bear. So another cool property of Unicode is that it fails elegantly. And I think there's no better example of this than with flags. The Unicode definition contains many, if not all, countries' flags, and these are all made up of 2 glyphs each. What's cool here is that while they are unfortunately not implemented in my font, there have been plans such that they would render as a 2-letter country code, with one code point representing 1 letter. So among these letters, if you put together a valid 2-letter country code, you will get the emoji representation of its flag. I thought it's quite genius. Anyway, I think you get the idea and you're probably itching to try it yourself, so let me point you to a few resources. Check the video description for a full list of the official Unicode emoji. Fair word of warning, it's a huge page, it's gonna take a while to load. And finally, my Emoji Combiner web app is also available for you to play with. I have this tab here with a bunch of favorites as well that I thought you might like, so you can check it out, but feel free to try out any other combinations and see how they work out too. But that's it. That's all there is for this episode. Until next time, you're watching 0612 TV with NERDfirst.net. Thank you very much for watching. If you like this video and are feeling generous, a donation to this channel will be greatly appreciated. There's a link on screen and in the video description for more details. Meanwhile, please do like, comment, and subscribe. This helps the channel tremendously and gives me the means to do more. Thank you once again, and I'll see you next time.